rejoice. We will be glad in it. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. 477 in our hymn book. The Black National Anthem. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring through the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. We will sing all three verses.
Thank you.
Absolution. O Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy great mercy have promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn to thee, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all of our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The collect together. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To sanct us, it is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. The tribes have gone together, therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven. We loud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord, most high. Amen. This morning's scripture reading will be taken from Psalm 62. Psalm 62, verse 1 and 2, and I will be reading from the New King James Version. 62, verse 1 and 2. Truly, my soul silently waits for God. From him comes my salvation. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Today we are starting our celebration of African American history.
Amen.
And our theme this month is My Soul Looks Back and Wonders.
Mm-hmm.
And Pastor just read our theme scripture, which was Psalm 62, verses 1 and 2. And just to say this, that we are spirit beings and we have a soul.
Yes.
And our soul is our mind, our will, and our emotions.
Amen.
And we live in a body. But again, our theme is our souls, or my soul looks back and wonders.
Amen. Amen. How I got over.
Yes.
Amen.
How I Got Over is a gospel hymn composed and published in 1951. By Clara Ward. The song was notably sung by the Clara Ward Singers, Aretha Franklin, the Blind Boys of Alabama, and Mahalia Jackson in 1961. And in 1963, at the historic March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom before 250,000 people. The song says, my soul looks back and wonders how I got over. This means the singer is marveling over how he or she made it through the hardships faced in life. The song provides the answer. It was with God's help that we got over.
Amen.
Some of the lyrics are, and I want to thank him for how he brought me. And I want to thank God for how he taught me.
Yes.
Oh, thank my God how he kept me.
Yes.
I'm gonna thank him
well,
because he never left me.
No, no.
Yes.
I'm
And on the flyer that is on Facebook, on our Facebook page for Mass Memorial, you'll also see a quote from Dr. Maya Angelou about how she says how she made it over.
Praise the Lord.
Or how her soul looks back and wonders. But with that in mind, talking about this poise, I want to read for you today the Black Family Reunion Pledge by Dr. Maya Angelou. Because we have forgotten our ancestors, our children no longer give us honor. Because we have lost the path our ancestors cleared kneeling in perilous undergrowth, our children cannot find their way. Because we have banished the God of our ancestors, our children cannot pray. Because the old wails of our ancestors have faded beyond our hearing, our children cannot hear us crying. Because we have abandoned our wisdom of mothering and fathering, our befuddled children give birth to children they neither want nor understand. Because we have forgotten how to love, the adversary is within our gates and holds up the mirror of the world, shouting, "Regard the loveless." Therefore, we pledge to bind ourselves to one another,
yes,
to embrace our lowliest, to keep company with our loneliest, to educate our illiterate, to feed our starving, to clothe our ragged, to do all good things, knowing that we are more than keepers of our brothers and sisters. We are our brothers and sisters.
Yes.
In honor of those who toiled and implored God with golden tongues, and in gratitude to the same God who brought us out of hopeless desolation, we make this pledge. Black Family Reunion Pledge by Dr. Maya Angelou.
Amen.
Pass it back in your hands.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Sharon, and thank you, Brother Tyrone. As we celebrate and commemorate Black History Month, let us never forget the sacrifices that was made by ancestors.
Amen.
That's the reason why we're here today. We're standing on their shoulders.
Yes.
And somebody say amen to that.
Amen.
So we praise God. And so we will never forget our history nor our heritage.
Yes.
But most of all, we will never forget the God who has brought us to where we are today.
Amen.
Right. Amen.
Amen.
Let us now receive a couple of announcements from Sister Swanee. Well, one announcement, and then I have an announcement. Amen. Good to see you, Sister Swanee.
Amen. Good to be seen.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I would like to invite you all to our annual Mid-Michigan Ministers, Spouses, Widows, and Widowers, our annual Vesper service this afternoon at 4 o'clock. Sister Marilyn so graciously shared the flyer with you all, and we'd like you to come and join us, and I'm sure that you will be blessed. Thank you.
Amen. Very worthy cause. We look forward to participating in that Vesper service and supporting our district minister spouses. Amen. I do want Marilyn to lift up our the Juneteenth brunch, jazz brunch. Please lift that up, my sister. But we want everyone to participate as much as possible.
Amen. Thank you, Mass Memorial. Certainly, as the founding church of Juneteenth here in Lansing, we're celebrating 30 years this year, and one of our fundraising events is to celebrate by hosting our jazz brunch fundraiser. It is Saturday at Gregory's. We do have very little tickets available. It's been a great effort on behalf of the committee. Where we will have brunch. We will have a number of things. We have art exhibits, and certainly we have jazz, not just from Lansing, but also from the Detroit area. So we're looking forward to that. For everyone that's put up the effort, for everyone who's already blessed us by your commitment, we want to say thank you. And again, we're celebrating 30 years, and this is one of our kickoff activities as a fundraiser. And we've been continued to be blessed to be able to do this for 30 years now. So thank you for your support. Thank you for those that we'll see, and for those who are still wanting to be with us, please see me. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Let's praise God for Sister Marilyn.
Amen.
And the wonderful work that is being done in this community.
Amen.
By way of Juneteenth here at Mass Memorial. Let's give God some praise for that. 30 years on the battlefield. We thank God for. So let's go out and show our support. Amen. Also, I do want to thank Dr. Linda Logan for her message on last week.
Amen.
Amen. Just want to remind Mass Memorial on Saturday, February the 25th. There we will be hosting a mid-year meeting with our presiding elder, Reverend Dr. Tawana A. Harris. Amen. So we look forward to hosting this event. And I'm asking the trustees to let us prepare rooms for various auxiliaries as they will need meeting space. And then I will get a count of how many will be staying for lunch. Amen.
Amen.
So we're looking forward to it. And we thank God that we can do this on behalf of our God, who has, in all that we do for his glory. Amen?
Amen.
It requires a little sacrifice. Amen?
Amen.
It requires a little service. But we'll be all right. Amen?
Amen.
Can anybody be God-given? You can. You can, no matter how hard you try.
That he Put away the gods which your father served on the other side of the river, serve the Lord. Y'all see that exclamation point after that?
Amen.
And if it seems evil to you to serve the Lord, choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. This message comes from the theme, Our Soul Looks Back and Wonder. Our Soul Looks Back and Wonder. From, I'd like to use as a subtitle this message, Our Community Dream. Our Community Dream. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
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 Our community dream as our soul looks back. When we consider our past, when we look to our future as African-American community, to see what decisions that can be made to better our communities. Some think we should go backwards, while others think we should just forget the past and take a totally new approach. What route do we take? How do we decide? A story is told of three old men who sat around on their porch holding a good luck charm. The first carried a rabbit's foot. And this rabbit foot, he said, has brought me more good luck than anything I know. I don't leave home without it. And the other had a horseshoe that he had hung over the door of his house. If there's a horseshoe over the door, there will always be good luck, he declares. Third man pulled out a small piece of paper and waved it. What's on this paper is all I need. I don't need a rabbit's foot because it didn't bring any luck to the rabbit. I don't need a horseshoe to hang over my door to fall and hit me in the head. And what's on this paper is my good luck charm. Curious, the other two men insisted that he read the note on the paper, and it read, In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. The old man looked up and said, You don't need luck when you got the Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, we don't need any luck today.
Amen.
When we got the Lord. And as Christians, we know that we have many options that are before us. Many have been tried by generations before us. But one thing has remained true, that when we give our lives to the Lord, He will never let us down.
Amen.
For if it had not been, my brothers and sisters, for the Lord on our side,
Amen.
Where would we be? Our soul looks back, and we wonder how we got over.
Amen.
Our text this morning considers Joshua as he assembled the men of Israel together to give them a challenge. Joshua, the successor of Moses, led Israel in miraculous battles that resulted in victory, conquering the land of Canaan. Now in his declining years, Joshua called all the men of that community together, that nation together, to talk with them about their responsibilities as men. As the men gathered at Shechem, Joshua reflected on the long journey, the people that they had, the challenges that lay before them, and he reminded them of their history. In other words, in essence, he says, our soul looks back, and we wonder how we made it this far. He pointed out to them that that even though they had challenges, amen, that God brought them through. But he also reminded them of their mistakes. In verse 2 of that chapter, he cites Terah, the father of Abraham, as an example of a man who chose to serve false gods. He reminded the people that how their ancestors served the false gods in Egypt. Amen. And some of the children of Israel thought it a matter of survival to worship these gods of Egyptians. And many of them hoped to gain favor of their oppressors. So in detail, Joshua noted that the journey of the people from this small Mandarin tribe to a great nation was not by accident, but it was carefully guided, amen, by God. Each step of the journey was a planned execution of the will of God for their lives. So beginning in verse 3, Joshua, speaking as an instrument of God, recalls the details of their plans. Amen. So Joshua, what reminds the children of Israel what God had promised to Abraham and his descendants, how it would be fulfilled. And in verse 6, he showed them how God, amen, would bring them out of slavery and how he would destroy the efforts to re-enslave them in Egypt. And then verse 8, he details how Israel, as a small, untrained nation of former slaves, were able to defeat the forces superior to them because God said, "I fought with you and I gave them into your hands. The Lord will fight our battles." But now in the promised land, the Israelites were enjoying this wonderful prosperity. This was unparalleled. And in verse 13, God reminds them that they now own land for which they did not labor, cities that they did not build, resources that they did not develop themselves. Unfortunately, in light of all this prosperity, in the land of plenty, there was still a desire for some to follow the gods of the Amorites. So before slavery, during slavery, and even after slavery, some men worshiped these gods for whatever reason. I believe that even though they were no longer slaves, but still possessed a slave mentality, choosing to serve the gods of the Amorites rather than the only true and living God. Joshua's challenge to the men was blunt. Choose the false gods or choose the present God, or stick with the one true God who have brought us where we are today. Amen. Where a land flowing with milk and honey. Joshua, being the godly man that he was, made this historic proclamation. You choose who the gods that you decide to choose, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. In our African-American community, men, amen, we need men to assemble today the same manner as the children of Israel and their men assembled that day under Joshua. Amen. And the discourse might be the same. As leaders of our nation, in our communities, in our homes, African-American men have much to be thankful for. We do. God has been good to us. In fact, he has been better to us than we have been to ourselves. Yes, we've got challenges, but with God on our side, if God is for us, amen, then who can be against us? Even before slavery, even during, and nearly over 250 years, slavery existed in this country. There were some among us that chose to serve other gods instead of the one true living God. Some have made their choice out of ignorance, perhaps looking for good luck charms and cheating their brothers and sisters, amen, committing crimes. And there were some who were willing to do anything, to put up with anything to get what they wanted. Today, there is a generation, unfortunately, of black men who are standing on the shoulders of our ancestors. And we are able to assess many of the finer things in life only because they have been given to us the help of God. And so we need to praise God right now for what we have. Amen. That you're living in a home. That the blood is running warm in your veins. You got a car. You got money in the bank. God has been good. Amen. That's because our ancestors built churches. They built communities. They built homes. Amen. Our fathers, with the help of God, fashioned programs to teach our children, to educate our people, to train our boys, to groom our girls, and to protect our homes and our neighborhoods. As African Americans, we have successfully come through the horrors of the Middle Passage, Reconstruction, lynching, KKK, Black Codes, the Civil Rights Movement, Reaganomics, Voodoo Economics, the war in Iraq, and a January 6th insurrection. Amen. To this point in our history, amen, God has been good to us. And my brothers and sisters, just follow the example that was laid out in this book of Joshua as the Israelites took in biblical times. The path, unfortunately, of least resistance. They still believe, they still have struggling with serving the Lord today. So black men today, we face challenges, don't we? Just as the men of Joshua's time. It was a matter of choosing whether to follow the God of their fathers and lead their families and communities, amen, or whether to seek their own personal ambitions and allow their families to stray and to serve false gods. Well, what are the false gods of our time? Well, they're not statues which we bow down to, but they're more than likely ideals and lifestyles that are degrading to our community and our people. Amen. And that comes to us, amen, via the social media. Amen. That devalues our youth and our lifestyles. Serving the false gods, unfortunately, of social media. And then there are the false gods that are eating away at our community, destroying our families. And one is, of course, drugs and alcohol and crime. And these three combined have done more to diminish the effort and the presence of African-American men than anything else in our community. How can we have fathers and husbands and leaders, amen, in our community leading if they're shot up, locked up, and doped up and drugged up? It is a false god that threatens us before and during slavery, and it still threatens us today. Another a false god among us is the upward mobility god. And there are many who are not drunks, they're not drug dealers, but just as absent from their families because they worship, amen, the career ladder, the god of money, which absorbs all of their time and all of their resources and all of their efforts. They often find themselves mere shells of men because they worship the god of money. And as African American men, let us do away with these false gods, and let us turn and acknowledge the one true and living God, for it is in him we live, in him we move, and in him we have our very being. In him we have more, a noble heritage, a meaningful presence, amen, in our community, and an even more glorious future. Amen. In America, we tend to put more emphasis on ethnic identity. Amen. Joshua and the children of Israel knew who they were. They knew their historical fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And in the 1960s, there were a number of black folks raising questions about their historical family and their family roots because of the way slavery had cut us off from the roots in our African ancestry. Amen. There were a number of blacks saying historically they didn't know who they were. And that's why the members of the Nation of Islam used the letter X as their last name. They said they did not know their true African names, only the American slave given names from their slave masters. So X stood for our unknown past. Amen. My soul looks back and wonder, But my brothers and sisters, the cross stands for our unknown past, our present, and our future. Regardless of where we have come from in Africa, we are all sinners, my brothers and sisters. So the cross identifies us as children of God. And if we accept the Lamb of God who was given to take away the sins of the world, we will be assured of who we are. Because of the cross, I am a child of God. Because of the cross, I am seated in heavenlies with Christ. Because of the cross, I am an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ Jesus. Because of the cross, I am more than a conqueror. I am victorious. And so we need not feel lost historically, sociologically, and physiologically, or any other way, when we know that we are children of the Most High God. And when we look back and our soul wonders, we have a heritage that goes further back than the Iraq War and voodoo economics and Reaganomics and the Civil Rights Movement and black codes and lynchings and Reconstruction and slavery and the Middle Passage. Goes farther back than human history itself as children of God. Amen. Amen. We are made in the image and likeness of God. And we were made a little lower than the angels, and we were crowned with glory and honor. We may not know who we are historically, but we know whose we are. We are essentially His children. Amen. And we may not know our specific historical ancestors, but we know our Heavenly Father, the Creator of the universe. We are to worship the Lord our God, and Him only shall we serve. But the ultimate quest, my brothers and sisters, the ultimate aim, the ultimate goal for black men in our community, if we're going to fulfill our community dream, we should be what Dr. Hake, oh my goodness, say it, Brother Brown. There he is. Thank you, brother. Thank you, brother. He describes in his book Black Men as the ultimate quest, which is to be responsible, loving, and effective husbands and fathers. That we should be committed not to allow racism to destroy our spirit or our values. And as we build upon the past, amen, that every black man should commit himself to building his family and making sure that he is not just a casual visitor or a sperm donor, but a vital part of his home and his community. And I pray that these 9 points that was given by Dr. Brown said, I can't pronounce his name, but I pray that these 9 points might guide us to teach us by example, amen, to marshal fidelity and integrity and racial appreciation, not racism. These are taught by living examples, amen. And then work hard at being a father. Learn from your mistakes, amen. 3, promote opportunities for your children to develop creativity in arts and in music and in dance and in drama. 4, create and participate in activities as a family. Never allow members of your family to fragment and go in different directions without family support. Then 5, abstain from controlled substances and drinking and using profanity, amen. Let's teach our children how to talk. Amen. All that other stuff, that French that we use, we need to just talk English around. Hello, somebody. I'm trying to be nice. We're raising a family. Amen. And we need to be spiritually and mentally alert for the sake of our children. 6, do not hit your wife. Don't even hit her. Amen. She's a queen. Amen. Don't hit your queen. Amen. Love her. Then 7, maintain a home that is culturally in tune with the best of African-American culture, with art and books and periodicals and visuals that reflect the best contributions of our people. Then 8, teach our children that no matter how painful it may be, that to teach them to be disciplined, to be focused, to be honest. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And to strive to achieve their best. And then the final challenge to black men is to point their family in the direction of the one true and living God. Black, my black brothers, we should realize that our children idolize us. They desire to emulate our best qualities. Amen. And we should show them an active faith in God, coming to church and worshiping God. Let them children see you pray at night. Amen. Let them see you worship God and come to church. And Joshua decided this. He said, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And the reason Joshua could make this statement on behalf of his family was because he knew his family would follow his example, because he lived it. And this was not a positive rhetoric. Amen. It's good to be positive, but we should mean what we say and say what we mean. Amen. We need to live by example. It's good to be a man that knows how to use their hands, but it's better to be a man, amen, who knows how to put their hand in God's hand. It's good to be a man who knows how to put food on the table, but it's better to be a man who knows from whom all blessings flow. It's good to be a man who is well known, but it's better to be a man who knows the Lord. Men who believe in the death and the burial and the resurrection of Jesus Christ and accept him as their Lord and Savior. Men who walk with the Lord, who talk with the Lord. Men who know what it means to say, Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart. Men who knows what it means when it says, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Men who knows what it means to say, a charge to keep I have, a God to glorify, an ever-dying soul to save, fitted for the sky. Men who refuse to give up when times get tough, because they know trouble don't last always. Men who refuse to accept defeat, but kick defeat right in the face. Amen. Men who refuse to allow problems to get the best of them, because they know the Lord will make a way somehow. But my brothers and sisters, amen, when we look back and when we wonder how we got over, we do know how we got over, don't we? We do know how we got past pain and prejudice. We do know how we got through trauma and tribulation. We do know how we got beyond bigotry and bitterness. We do know how we succeeded standing strong. We do know how we exceeded our expectations with education. We do know how we defeated the devil and his demons. We do know who brought us through every raging storm, every raging sea. We do know who brought us, amen, through every mountain and every exalted valley and through every crooked place. We do know who brought us this far by faith, leaning on the Lord. We do know who brought us through every test and trial. We do know who brought us through lynchings and fear and intimidation. If it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be? Our soul looks back. We wonder how we got over. We got over because God intended us to get over. We got over because God gave us the victory in Christ Jesus. We got over because God was at work, working all things together for the good. Condemned by Pilate, they put him on a cross, they spit
Thank you.
touch me in my house. We will serve the Lord. Amen. Let us now prepare our hearts to go to the table. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, walking henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith. Take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling on your knees. The prayer of humble access. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies, we are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs on thy table. But thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful souls and bodies may be made clean by his death, and washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Amen.
Prayer of consecration, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, will thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his oblation of himself, once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel, commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it, gave to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink it, in remembrance of me. My brothers and sisters, take now the cup. Just pull the top layer off. Now, let us hold up the bread. Let us now eat it together. May it preserve your souls and bodies under everlasting life. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. After supper, he took the cup. Take now the cup, which represents the blood that was shed for you and for many. Let us drink it together. May it preserve your souls and bodies with everlasting life. That blood that gives us strength from day to day, it will never lose its power. Let us pray now the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us of our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The tradition, we will follow the tradition of the disciple Jesus and the disciples, that after the meal they sang a hymn and they had fellowship. Let's join in fellowshipping and singing a hymn together. Sister Sharon, did you want to come and let us know what's next as far as this? Okay.
Next week, since it's Youth Sunday, Sister Deborah and Brother Marcus and Sister Mariah, I'm sure we'll have something together for the young people for Youth Sunday for our African American History Celebration.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Sister Sharon. Also, we commend you for your insightful Sunday school lesson this morning. Was it the elite? What was that? The elite?
Well, not many elite called.
Not many elite called. Amen. And she did a great job explaining how Paul mentioned that he did not want to argue with anyone about God or about what he thought was right. But concentrate on the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. So thank you, Sister Sharon. And of course, we thank Sister Young for sending out the quarter lessons for the weeks to come. Amen. Hate to let you go. Good to see you, Mother Tommy. God bless you. I'm going to give Mother Tommy a hand. Amen. Good to see you. And good to see everyone. Amen. Let's give this choir another hand. Let us stand on our feet for the doxology and the benediction. Sweet communion of